It's shocking me, but AI is actually fixing Revit parameters for me. I added 45 small tools to AI, and now AI changes the names of rooms and sheets, edit parameters, and color elements based on types. So let's jump into Revit. So I got this model over here. It's a simple warehouse in the Netherlands, nothing very fancy. And I'm going to actually be using this. I'm going to be using Claude and the AI connector. I'm not going to do a full introduction of this. There is another video in the channel that actually explains a little bit more. So if it's the first time you see, feel free to check it out. The first thing I'm going to be doing is to fixing the room names in this view. So I'm going to copy paste this here. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to first find the rooms in my current view, and from there to fix their name in Revit to show it standardized and capitalized. So I have all these rooms. There are some of them are in lower cases with abbreviations and so on. I want AI to fix it for me. So the AI is actually going to first find the tools that it needs to use, and from there start using them. So it's getting the active view, then it's jumping into getting some elements in the view. From there is getting all the rooms, well, the room category, sorry. From there is getting all the rooms IDs. And after that, it starts getting the parameters. So that's for getting the names of the actual rooms. And now got all the names. Hopefully, I see that all the names has been changed. So it updated all the names using the set parameter value for elements, and all the room names were changed, but it also selected the rooms. I didn't ask for that, but that's also nice. I mean, if I want to to visualize them easier in the view. It's finishing up some small things. Okay, so yeah, it's just concluding that. So that's one of the use cases to actually change the names of rooms, but there's some other cool things that this can do. So I'm going to create a new chat here, and I'm going to go here and copy paste this here. So what I want to do now is I have some sheets in the model that start with DO. Let me close this here. So these are here, and I want the AI to actually translate all this. The model is in Dutch, and I want the AI to translate the view names the sheet names into English. So I just asked for it, and I just explained that I just want the DO because these are title sheets. That's also fine. So first getting the sheet category, and then from there start looking for the elements and getting parameters to find those that start with DO. And after that is getting parameter values, thinking. Perfect, now I have all the Dutch names. So one of the cool things is that after running each tool, it has some thought process. So it can actually think about the information it got from Revit and then work on that. It changed all the names already. So I can see that all the names were translated. And that's pretty cool as well. That's also harder to automate because making this semantic or meaning-based requests are hard to make with written code. So with AI, I think AI can actually help a lot in those. And the last thing I want to make is I want to actually close this, minimize this, and I'm going to open four views that I have. This view is meant to be used for a different room. They have no scope box assigned, so I'm just gonna do the tile view here. So none of them have any scope box or anything assigned, and I want the AI to make those assignments for me. So for that I also created the scope boxes in Revit, and I'm just gonna fix the view here a little bit and here, and I'm going to create a new chat here and then copy paste this here. So what I'm asking now is to, I can take this out, is to, to detect my open views in Revit and assign them the corresponding scope box which matches their name. So because the view is named with the name of the room and the scope box as well, the AI is able to cross that information and to assign the scope boxes to the different views. So let me get closer here. So it first gets the active view, so it found all the views that I've opened, and then from there gets all the scope boxes. It found that there are eight, and then start getting their names. And I can see that Revit just changed. It assigned them. So if I go here actually to the project browser properties and I open this, I can just confirm that this is DO006, DO006, DO003, 003, 004, 004, 002. So that's something that AI can actually help me do. I mean, of course, I could open all the views one by one, but that would take me a little bit longer, I think. And there are other cool things like coloring elements or preparing reports and so on. So I think that's it for this video. Feel free to check the other one in which I prepare some reports as well with AI. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.